Hello there, people. Delta Blues Tips here. Oh. I know I've been missing for a long time now. I'm not. I've just been unwell, one thing after another, non-stop, just going on and on. And pretty much unable to play to the extent that I used to play. Which has made life quite depressing, I can tell you. One thing I discovered on the way was this tea that I'm drinking here. This is Assam tea. And this particular one I discovered, it's probably not the best Assam tea. I don't know what the best Assam tea is. This is just one that I picked up in Tesco's. It's the finest Assam tea, which probably isn't really fine at all, seeing as Tesco's is a fucking glorified pound shop, innit? Let's face it. But I have to say, this particular one, if you're in the UK and you're looking for a nice wet tea, this is my new tea. I haven't drank Yorkshire tea now for months since I discovered this. And it's not really that expensive when you think of Tesco's is really expensive. Most of it's shite really, let's face it. But this one, I think it's £1.49 for 50 tea bags. I'm going through a fair amount of it, I can tell you. It's really good. So I want to show you, before I go anywhere. Those of you who've been following the plight of Iris, my little French romantic guitar. And if you go right back through my videos on this channel, you'll see a video I made actually when I was in the Samaritans about this guitar. As I recall on the video, I do say I met some fine people there, which is quite embarrassing now when you look back and think back. It's like one of them emails you didn't mean to send. Turns out they were arseholes. But anyway, I got this guitar and it's finally been repaired and restored. I'm going to show you it now. Now, I only got it back today. And I don't know whether you can see on the camera here, but there's been a strip put in right along here. Can you see the difference in the colour there where my finger's following it? Because that's where it goes right the way through, I think. Oh, yeah, it does. Right the way through here. That's where the top had fell in. I didn't notice that it fell in with the strain on the arm. Now what he's done with the neck is he's taken the frets out and sanded the neck, the fingerboard, right down to take the bow out of it so that it now lies flat, as you can see. I didn't know this, but he showed me that you take the measurement for on top of this, and that's how the neck should lie, which is now done. And he's given me a pretty standard Martin, what a Martin action would be, pretty much close to me, 0028 really. Now it's got, and of course this had been put on, this is not the original one. Those who followed it will see the original one on the guitar. This is what the other guy put on for me. And John informed me that if he'd have got his hands on it in the first place, he would have kept the original bridge. But I didn't know this at the time, obviously. So I'm gutted about that, but this is a new bridge in here. Gives it a nice sustain. Frets are back in, cleaned up. I can't remember, but I think he may have put another nut in. But I'm not sure, it might be the same one, I can't really remember when I think back. It looks like he has to me, like, but then again, I don't know really. He's swapped some of these machine heads around because they weren't right or something. So they're done. See? But the main thing is, how does it sound? Now, when I put it into him, it was electric strings on it. And I think he's put another set on it now. Think, and he doesn't, we talked about it this morning, we don't think it suits electric strings now. But the reason I'm leaving them on for a little bit is so that I can sort of break it in again, get used to it. So it's still sitting weird. Such a pleasure to be able to actually play up and down the arm. And get into feeling the neck. The neck's quite wide on this, and it feels very different than the other ones. I'll have to get used to the spacing, because you know, I've never been able to play the thing properly. a little bit of So that's it with electric strings on. Let's wonder together what it's going to sound like when we actually get bronze strings on it. See, from the start of this video to just now, the way it's starting to breathe. It's gonna be better with just listen to the intonation on it. It's looking really good. Look at the back, isn't it great, the back there on this old guitar. This is possibly between 1860 and 1900. I don't actually know. Someone else told me that. But I think this binding wasn't around in 1860. I'm not sure, to be honest. So I think it might be 1900. Still an all. It's a very old guitar. I might think the way it was when I found it. With the action probably about that high off the board and no way of getting it back. I think it's done a marvellous job. Playing it, what I realise I need to do, whereas I just drop my thumb on my other guitar to catch that F note, it doesn't work with this one. I have to bring it over more, see? So I'll have to get used to it. Sound for such a small thing, eh? What a sound. So there we are. Now I'm hoping that this is going to make me, you know, start producing something. I have lots of ideas I want to do. Me be it there. Oops. I've got lots of ideas that I want to try. Depending on the shape I'm in, like, there's a bit a great band title if ever there was one. Depending on the shape I'm in, but there's no doubt about it. It is a long road. It's fucking been a long road the last 3 years. I can't tell you how long it's been. And I've let things go. I know I've let things go. I've let my videos go. I've let keeping this place tidy. It's only a small place, but even keeping this tidy, I can't really be bothered, to be honest with you. Well, now hopefully things are gonna come out right. And now I'd like to thank those who have kept me going for buying me discs. Someone, the last one I sold, I think was in the Arab Emirates. Those people have kept me ticking over, and one person in particular who's kept me going more than anything is a guy called Alan Smee in the UK. And I really want to thank him from the bottom of my heart. You really helped me out, mate. And I'll not forget you for that. Apart from that, I just want to say thank you for all the positive comments I've had on my channel. And I am getting it. And when I do, I'll start being groovy again. Which, I mean, I don't mean start being groovy again like I was groovy. I mean me playing wise, I'm talking about. Let's see if we can get that up to scratch. I am rehearsing every day, not every day, I'm rehearsing every 3 or 4 days now with me mate Ray. Those of you who've been on my Facebook guitar page, I mean following that, we are getting there, slowly but surely. And we brought me mate in Gary now. Sorry, me mate in Gary. Sorry, brought me mate Gary in, who's a bass player, and he plays guitar. So we've decided to promote him to guitar player and bass player. That's a joke between us, by the way. And it's a good little setup. We've got the three of us. We've got a few things to play, like this building and the people that run this building, the company that run it, and other buildings have asked us to play. We've been getting positive vibes from people who've heard what we do. it's just old fashioned stuff, really. It just gives us a chance to play, and it keeps my hand in, really. So I'm enjoying that. We're rehearsing tomorrow, actually, from about 3 onwards. It's nice vibe in the band. Vibe is anyone says anything they like. Anyone's got a suggestion for the tune to do, even if I don't like it as much. Or say Ray might not, or Gary might not. We do it. We don't argue. We just say, fucking do it. So it's really nice. I like that vibe. There's no like, let's try and do this note for note. We do it our own way. Make it hopefully sound nice. So there we are. There's all my news up to date. And if you haven't already done so, or you think you might want to buy one or two of my discs or downloads, well, just contact me. Apart from that, that was 21 minutes in the company of me and my new tea and Iris. I will be putting something up on me, hopefully me Facebook guitar page, and me playing a little bit of this. Let's see how it goes. Anyway, thanks a lot. I'll catch you later.